You'll have to forgive me if I seem a bit nervous. Not many people travelling in this part of Ferelden. Of course, that's part of my problem, isn't it? Mule got spooked by a wisp and ran off into the woods. Now what do I do?
Part of your problem?
Well, yes. Oh, it's been quite the month. Allow me to introduce myself. Felix de Grosbois, merchant and entrepreneur at your service.
I'm Leth. Pleasure to meet you.
I don't normally take this route, but with the war, I was hoping for a bit of luck and good weather in the mountains. Sadly, I've had neither. Ugh, this trip has been one miserable disaster after another. I don't suppose you'd consider helping a fellow out?
What exactly do you need?
Of all the other things that went wrong, the worst is this artifact I brought in Jada. It's a control rod, I'm told, for a golem. No point in me keeping it, however, as I'll never get to use it. But, maybe you could?
What does the control rod do? I mean, I guess it controls, but...
The dwarf I brought it from said it activates and controls a golem. So long as you have it in your hand, the golem does what you say. Might be useful, no? I mean, you look like the sort who could use one, yes?
How do I know this will even work?
The fellow I brought it from is a long-standing contact. He didn't want to come to Ferelden, however, with all our... troubles. He said he got it from the man who owned this golem. But to be honest, I have no idea if it will work. Hence the low, low price. What do you say?
What's the catch?
The catch? Yeah, I suppose it is a catch, isn't it? The catch is that the golem didn't come with the rod. It's supposed to be down in a village down south, waiting to be activated. Even if I could get down there, which I can't, I understand the place has been overrun by darkspawn. That's not such an issue for adventurous types like yourself, surely? Or I'm hoping that's so, at least.
How much do you want for it?
Nothing. I just don't want to have to lug around something that might be taken for a gemstone by some bandit. To be honest, I don't even know if it'll be useful to you. I paid too much to simply throw it away.
Yes, I think I could use it.
Just as well. As I mentioned before, you'll find the golem down south, in a town called Honleith. I'll mark it here on your map. Just hold up the rod and say Dulafgar. That will wake the golem up, so I'm told. I hope it works.
And if it doesn't?
Maybe you could look up the fellow who owned the golem before. If he's still about, that is. Best of luck to you then. Now, I guess it's up to me to find that mule myself.
This is a golem, I believe. Damaged, perhaps beyond repair. There may be a way to reactivate it, though that is not necessarily wise.
So, it's embedded with numerous crystals, some of them cracked. It may indicate that it's of dwarven make. Let's try Dulafgar. Nothing happens. Okay.
By the Maker, we're saved!
You weren't sent by the Ban, were you? To save us?
I doubt anyone thought you were still alive.
I suppose I should be grateful that someone came at all, then. Thank you. But if you weren't sent by someone, why are you here? If you don't mind me asking.
Well, I was looking for whoever owns the statue outside.
The statue outside? Why would... Oh, I think I see. You bought the control rod, didn't you? You came here looking for Shale.
Oh, is he a mage?
That damnable golem brought us nothing but trouble. My mother sold the rod years ago after it killed my father, and good riddance!
Killed your father? What do you mean?
My father's name was Wilhelm, mage to the Arls of Redcliffe and a hero in the war against Orlais, and what did he get? One day, my mother found him outside the tower, with so many broken bones she could barely recognize him, and shale standing over him, just like it is now. My father deserved better than that. But if you really want to wake Shale up, well, it's yours now.
I'm curious about this place, actually. Where are we?
This was my father's laboratory, beneath his tower. Or it was, anyhow. Look, I know you probably have more important things on your mind, but I really need your help. I know you already saved my life, and I'm grateful, but my daughter is inside the laboratory. She was afraid and ran too far in before I could stop her. I don't know how she made it past my father's defenses. One of the men tried to go after her. He was killed, but you could find her, couldn't you?
What killed this man who went after her?
There are defenses my father put down here to keep strangers out. I knew about the barrier, I had the key for that, but the rest of it, well, we never came down here, ever.
Okay, I'll see what I can do.
You will? Thank the Maker! My father's laboratory is just past the next area, I think. She has to be there.
Oh, look, someone's come to play. You have come to play, haven't you? We're playing a guessing game. It's better with more people.
Good, you're safe. Your father was worried.
Father? Oh, you can tell him I'm fine. Maybe he'll come and stay with us, too. Anyway, you should go if you're not going to play. Kitty finds you distracting.
The cat finds me distracting?
Kitty's clever. She says you want to take me back to my father, but I'm not going. She would be lonely.
You are so kind, Amalia. I would miss you dearly if you left.
Oh. That's not really a cat, is it?
Of course she's a cat. She just talks, that's all.
Talking is simple enough, once you know how.
Right. What are you, really?
I am a cat, really. Nothing you say will convince Amalia to go with you. She loves only me now. I am her friend. Well, you are just a stranger.
A stranger who finds you very interesting.
Oh. Did you hear that, Amalia? I have another admirer.
That's because you're wonderful, Kitty.
I have been bound to this chamber for decades, cut off from all contact. It has been maddening. Release me, mortal, and let me have the girl. Let us return to her father, and leave this place forever.
Don't you think you'll notice something out of place?
Mortals often allow themselves to be blinded by hope. They see what they wish to see. If the father hopes to see his Amalia alive and unharmed, perhaps he will. But I do like this one.
I like you too, Kitty.
But if it means escaping this prison, I am willing to leave on my own. I agree to your terms. The mage's wards hold me within this chamber, and only a mortal may approach them. There is a trick to disarming the wards, but I do not know it. Perhaps you will succeed where the girl failed.
Oh, this is so exciting! Kitty is going to be free! I've always wanted a cat, and Kitty is so perfect and pretty.
Yes. I can feel the magic fading. Oh, I had forgotten how it feels not to be caged.
Kitty, What's happening?
A wonderful thing, my dear, for both of us.
And where will you go after this?
Anywhere. I have changed my mind. I like the girl. I do not think I will find another like her.
Oh, so I get to go with you after all?
No, I will not allow this.
Ugh, I will take her anyhow. She is mine.
Kitty, you're scaring me. I won't let you inside me. I won't!
You force our hand.
You did it! You freed her! Thank you so much!
I'm sorry I ran away, Daddy. I was so scared.
It's all right, Butterfly. You're safe now. All the bad creatures are gone. You'll need a phrase to activate, Shale. It's Doolin Han. I wouldn't want the thing, but it's obvious you can handle yourself just fine. Now we should go, and quickly. Thank you again. We owe you our lives.
Doolin Han.
I knew that the day would come when someone would find the control rod. And not even a mage this time. Probably stumbled across the rod by accident, I suppose. Typical.
Hello to you too.
I stood here in this spot and watched the wretched little villagers scurry around me for, oh, I have no idea how long. Many, many years.
Oh, you poor dear. That would be really, really boring.
And the villagers had no idea they were being watched. Creepy.
I was just beginning to get used to the quiet, too. Tell me, are all the villagers dead?
I take it that wouldn't concern you?
Familiarity breeds contempt, as they say, and after 30 years as a captive audience, I was as familiar with these villagers as one could possibly be. Not that I wish their fate on them, no. But it did make for a delightful change of pace.
Did you watch the attack?
Not as much as it would think. There was running and screaming, and then days and days of watching the darkspawn prowl around. I would never have thought there could be something less interesting than the villagers, but there it was. Well, go on then. Out with it. What is its command?
Why are you calling me it?
Entrenched sense of perversity. The last one who held that damnable rod used to call me Gollum. Gollum, fetch me that chair. Do be a good Gollum and squash that insipid bandit. And let's not forget, Gollum, pick me up. I tire of walking. It does have the control rod, doesn't it? I am awake, so it must.
Is something wrong?
I see the control rod, yet I feel... Go on, order me to do something.
All right, walk over there.
And, nothing. I feel nothing. I feel no compulsion to carry out its command. I suppose this means the rod is... broken?
So, what now? You go on a killing rampage?
Don't be ridiculous. Well, I wouldn't mind killing the birds. Those evil birds and their foul droppings. I could crush them all. I suppose if I can't be commanded, this means I have free will, yes? It is simply What should I do? I have no memories beyond watching this village for so long. I have no purpose. I find myself at a bit of a loss. What about it? It must have awoken me for some reason, no? What did it intend to do with me?
I haven't given it much thought, honestly.
I see. Wonderful. I suppose I have two options, do I not? Go with it or go elsewhere? I do not even know what lies beyond this village.
Are you going to keep calling me it?
Yes, very likely.
So what do you want to do?
I watched this village for so long, unable to move or act. My memories of anything before are vague at best. So I have no idea what I want to do. I'm glad to be mobile. Is that not enough?
You killed your former master.
Did I? I remember that I had a former master. The mage with the furry brows who poked and prodded and barked orders. Did I kill him? I hope I did kill him. Perhaps the last order he barked was, Gollum, stop crushing my head. Ah!
I notice you don't call him it.
Yes, I'm just funny that way.
And how can I trust you?
I have no idea. How does it trust anything else without a control rod?
Well, good point, I guess.
They haven't killed it yet. I consider this a good sign.
All right, you're welcome to come with me.
Are you certain you want to bring that thing with us? It could be dangerous and large.
Think of it as a portable battering ram.
Good point. Better it than me, anyhow.
I will follow it about then, for now. I am called Shale, by the way.
Is that your name? Or what you're made of?
It would rather I was called Flint. Pebbles? How about rubble?
And now we have a companion, Shale.
Horse feathers.
Yes.
There he is.